Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. This video series shows you how to work with 3D models in Autodesk Smoke. In order to learn about some of the interoperability workflows, I will be using Autodesk Maya as my main 3D application. A key point to remember is that the interoperability is driven through the interchange formats like FBX. So you can actually use whichever 3D application you want, as long as it supports the Autodesk FBX plugin. If you would like to follow along, please click the link in the YouTube description to download the media. If you're watching the podcast version of this video, then type the link displayed in your internet browser. As most of you probably already know, all 3D applications work in their own unique way under the hood. However, when moving 3D assets between applications, we need to be as generic as possible to be able to recreate the same assets across applications in the pipeline. So there are lots of these issues which need to be addressed in preparation before exporting the FBX interchange format. So starting off, I have my spotlight and logo models. Whatever tools or modifiers I used to create these models have all been flattened and converted into polygons. This means any proprietary tools are converted into polygons, making the models generic for all applications. Next, going into the texture tools, there are quite a few models with textures. However, the important part is that any multi-layer textures are baked into a single texture per object. So one texture image per object will make the process smoother. The other part just to know about is the UV coordinates. The UV coordinates tell the 3D application how to wrap the texture on the model. So selecting this model and opening up the UV texture editor shows how this object is wrapped with its texture. The reason why I'm showing you this is because these coordinates are carried over into Smoke with the 3D model. This will allow you to retexture models and fix materials in Smoke without having to come back to the 3D applications. We'll have an example of this in a later video. The other part of the scene is the animation. As I scrub through the animation, have a close look at every model. Each model has object-driven animation. This means the entire model is animated as a singular object. They may be grouped or linked together, but the animation is object only. If you had created vertices animation for water rippling, curtains, or any dynamic simulation, you would need to create a point cache in order to export the data. This point cache will be covered in a later video series. The other components that make up the scene are lights and a camera. There is one main light that I am using to light my 3D models. And there is also a second light parented to the inside of the spotlight model. And finally, looking at a third-person perspective, there is a camera tracking move. The camera move was animated in Maya, but it could also have come from a 3D tracking application or even an exported camera from Smoke. Now we will export everything as an FBX file. Ensure the FBX file type is chosen and give your file a name. Some of the options that are worth mentioning is to ensure geometry animation is ticked, lights and cameras are ticked, and finally, embed media is turned on. This ensures that the textures are saved into the FBX and you won't have to manually texture the objects in Smoke. Click Export All and you're done. Switching over into Smoke, we will take what was created in the 3D application and continue the look development. I am running a 1080p 10-bit project running at 23.976. There is a 3-second black color source in the sequence, and we'll apply a connect effects to it to get it started. Drag out an action node from the connect effects node bin and drop it into the connection. Double-click on the node to bring up the Action node bin. Double-click on the Import node. In the file browser, change the file type from 3D Studio to FBX. Now navigate to the location of the FBX file. Select the file and look at the options at the bottom of the screen. We will import the model, lights, and camera. The textures will also be brought in as media. And the FBX scale option should be disabled. This affects the units of measurement as the model is imported. In the 3D applications, you can set the scene to be centimeters, meters, or something else. Smoke does not work with these units of measurement. Therefore, sometimes you will find your models importing tiny or huge. You could attempt to auto-fit the geometry into the scene, or manually set the unit measurement to pixel value. These options are a bit of trial and error, depending on what you want to do. Normally, the default settings work pretty well. The local copy tells you that Smoke will make its own version of this geometry and not link to the original FBX once imported. Press Load, and the 3D scene will be recreated in Smoke. Select the Action node and press Escape to see the Action Schematic view. If you haven't already done so, press Ctrl Option N to bring up the Navigator. This makes it easier to move around the nodes in the composite. They are clearly laid out, and it will become obvious what you're looking at as you go through the various videos. Now, before we start working on look development, let's change a few settings. Firstly, looking at the result view, we are still looking through the original 3D camera. Switch to the Object menu, and under the Default Camera tab, change the result camera from default cam to camera 2. The view switches, and now we have the same view as what we saw in Autodesk Maya. You can select the old camera node in the schematic and press H to hide it, as we don't need it anymore. Next, let's enable the lighting. Go to the node prefs, rendering tab, and enable shading. And finally, switch to the CFX preferences. Set the hardware anti-aliasing to 8 times to smooth out some of the model's edges. So we're off to a good start. In the next video, we'll use another model to create a spherical environment around our models. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.